Welcome. I just wanted to do a quick video before leaving this venue. It's certainly the most aesthetically pleasing venue I've been in so far with this exhibition, Living with PTSD. It's been an interesting place to exhibit at. And I just wanted to kind of capture this, the way it's been laid out, and to share a couple of thoughts. It's been an interesting journey. The rolling exhibition started in November 2013 after we'd secured funding from the Arts Council, and started in Leicester. Then we had the other exhibition running alongside it, which was Intimacy with Plants. So that started showing in Nottingham this year at George Thornton Art, which has been the best venue to date for that particular exhibition. And this is the best venue to date for this particular exhibition. So I've had to decide that the exhibition will stop after its showing in Nottingham, which is going to be from August through till October. It's a question of managing stress. It's not easy doing this kind of work. You're working with different people, different organisations, different ethos. And to try and keep your vision true while you're doing this has been, well, to keep my vision true while doing this has been quite difficult. Over the whole sort of, well, it will be just under a year when it finishes. Actually, it will be over a year when it finishes. The smaller exhibition, Intimacy with Plants, will keep going, and we'll keep working with smaller organisations, clubs, whatever, to continue raising awareness of PTSD. And shutting down the exhibition will allow me to continue working with other groups in the community to continue more awareness raising. If you've enjoyed the exhibition, if you've been, there is a book list. There's a book at the top there called Living with PTSD. It's the accompaniment to the exhibition. And if I go in close enough, there's the ISBN 978-0956-488541. That's the book. It's got all of the images from the exhibition in there. And I'd like to thank everybody that has helped with the exhibition in whatever way. There have been many people. I would like to thank those of you that have come to the exhibition and supported it, viewed it. I've heard stories from people, some whose stories have been quite horrendous. They're still living with PTSD. They're being subjected to discrimination, to stigma, to being ostracized. They're not getting the right sort of support from the system. And this is veterans and non-veterans alike. Some of the behavior that people are being subjected to that have PTSD is absolutely atrocious. So it's been good to hear your stories and to be able to signpost you to different sort of avenues of support. And the work of the project will carry on, but in a different way now. It is a not-for-profit project. If you've enjoyed any of the prints and you would like to buy one, please do so, as it will help to finance this project and to carry the work on. Same with the books. None of it sort of is squandered away in salaries or anything like that. This is a therapeutic work project, and your support would be appreciated. Please do tell people about the project. The main website is www.wolf-photography.com, and there's a special domain name being set up for the resources. So if you're looking for treatment, if you're looking for support, you may find some help, as I'll be linking to more and more organisations as I become aware of them. and that is www.lwptsd.com. And you'll also find a link to that section from the main website. Just look at the help section and click on Living with PTSD. Thank you again for supporting this exhibition, and good luck in whatever you do in life. If you have PTSD, I sincerely hope that you find the support that you need, and a better way of life. Bye.